Everyone asked me why I came to China. They used to ask me why I came to China, as if there was some fault, some strange reason. They kept asking me this question, even today. The truth is, I do not have an answer. So I used to make up answers. I still do not have an answer. But now I am tired of China as I have come to know it. This is not the China I came to 22 years ago. This was not why I came to China. For advice about how to make money in China. So the phone is always ringing, 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 ringing. Sometimes they expect me to wait for an email. I tell them to stop sending me emails because I cannot believe that life can be concentrated and reduced to one single digitized electronic message, which is not even spelled correctly. And a mobile phone goes ringing through the pulse of mind for as long as you can stand the stress factor induced by excessive talking. Shangri-la. So I began to ask myself the question, what am I doing here? Why did I come to China? Then I had a dream. It came back to me every night. I had dreams of wild Tibetan ponies, white ponies, running in uncertain directions. They were running across a vast Tibetan plain. It was surrounded by snow-capped mountains. So I decided to follow the Tibetan ponies. One day I sat in a Beijing Starbucks drinking coffee with pop singer Ai Jing. I told her about the Tibetan ponies. I described the place. A vast Tibetan plain, snow-capped mountains. It sounded like Shangri-la, a place she'd heard about once, maybe twice.
其实中国应该还有很多地方，你不知道，香格里拉除了这些大城市以外，香格里拉西部啊，云南啊，西藏啊，还有香格里拉。我跟你说，我也没去过，我也很想往这些地方来。我觉得你不妨去看一看。
I told Ai Jing that I was going out west in search of an uncertain direction, in search of Shangri-La.
Good luck for you.
Okay, thank you.
Searching for Shangri-La. It could be found in a cup of coffee latte, if one looked carefully enough. I looked into my cup of coffee latte and didn't understand. She said I was not looking carefully enough. Tibet. I left the airport. I thought the search for Shangri-La should begin in Lhasa, but was not completely sure.
Shangri-La, I've never been there.
我也不知道.
I don't know.
I don't know what Shangri-La is.
Shangri-La 是个饭店的名字.
I don't know at all.
I don't know what Shangri-La means either.
Shangri-La, I don't know.
It is said upon arriving in Tibet, one should stop at a temple before entering Lhasa. It is only said to be alongside the road. So I followed the road. Then I came to a temple. I did not know whether it was the right temple or not, but I went in anyway. And after asking the monks whether this was the right temple, they said there were a lot of temples on the road to Lhasa. They asked me which one I was looking for. I asked a monk for directions. The monk explained to me that if you want to begin searching for directions, you should begin with a cup of yak butter tea. I tried to explain that I was searching for a place called Shangri-la. They poured another cup of yak butter tea. I drank it. I left the temple and hitchhiked down the road. There was a large Buddha carved in the rock. You could see the statue from the road, but could not touch it unless you crossed the river. A young boy offered to lead me across the river. I asked the stone Buddha to help me find Shangri-la. The young boy asked for money.
So to me, Shangri-La, it's an American dream.
很美好.
是一个梦中的仙境.
For me, Shangri-La
is a paradise.
Imaginary country.
Is a holy land.
Hidden country.
Very exciting.
Shangri-La is inside of you.
We try to find it.
And when I give him this, what should I?
本来我们说佛陀的发祥地应该是在印度啊.
Then he give back to you this.
但是今天我们不能不承认.
Not a longer question.
香格里拉的这个种子, 不仅仅种在这个青藏高原, 世界屋脊,
对.
而且呢, 发芽, 开花, 结果的都在这.
He's so old, you know. He can't and.
所以我感谢我的前辈, 包括松针干部藏娃, 他们用一辈子的这个功德, 先把佛法从印度背来, 就是徒步背来, 向了哈马谷, 向着死在路头, 所以我们藏民族, 虽然它有个缺点, 就是经济落户, 但是呢, 这个民族有个, 我觉得自豪的东西, 就是心灵, 非常的自在, 舒服。
Vera Ginste Rinpoche is one of the highest-ranking living Buddhas in the Tibetan Black Order. At the age of 7, he started studying Buddhism. Now, he travels the world, lecturing and teaching meditation. There is suffering and peace, he explained. Shangri-La is Shambhala, which means the future, but it cannot be reached through modern telecommunication. Only by practicing meditation can we reach Shangri-La.
We can communicate all the world, but Shangri-La cannot communicate. If you practice, meditate, you can reach this. And then Shangri-La, they have a lot of quality. Great kings, great peaceful, great, and Shangri-La is a rich place, also less suffering.
其实到拉萨来看一看是对的，是来感受是对的。上周我有很多很好的朋友，包括国外的，有国内的。他们说，一回到拉萨，就好像真正的把自己的全部东西平静下来，就觉得很舒服，把自己失去的一种东西找回来了。但是呢，他说又回到那个国外或者内地，工作也忙，时间也比较急，所以他说又把自己的这个心灵又给污染了，寻找这个香格里拉。 希望呢，不仅仅是到这个西藏大昭寺来寻找这个灵感，更主要的还是要自己去了解更多的这个净化这个心灵，或者寻找香格里拉的秘方。我相信，你不一定到大昭寺来，你不一定去回到西藏，你可以在你的家乡，不管在美国或者是所有的哪个国家，都可以找到它。
其实我觉得就是每个人，我是这么觉得啊，就每个人都有自己的一个心目当中的香格里拉，好像每个人都在去寻找这样的一个东西。Sambal,
recognized as China's greatest music composer today,
is an ethnic Mongolian fusing traditional and modern music.
可能每个人的
角度不一样，不同，都会去以自己的一种习惯的方式去找自己的这种幻想当中的这样一个东西。蒙古族也有活佛，
是，
对，也是也有喇嘛庙啊，什么什么的这样的。哈达，他也是献哈达，是，这我从小的时候我都知道。其实我小的时候我以为是哈达，还有什么这些东西是蒙古的才有的。后来我长大以后才知道，哦，藏族也有献哈达呀，啊，什么。后来我才知道，哦，蒙古的这个教是从藏人这样传过来的。
Shotan Yogurt Festival begins with pilgrimages to mountains beside temples. Inside these temples, great tanka are kept. The tanka are so large in size that they may be spread across the surface of a mountain. Once a year in the early morning, over 100 monks, lost in trance of chants and drone of Tibetan horns, will lift the great tanka upon their shoulders to the height of a mountain.Unrolling the tanka within seconds before sunrise, so the first rays of light may touch the Buddha's face. As the sun rises, the early rays touch Buddha's eyes. Eagles dance in the wind. They do not know that prayer is given and blessing received, or that moments are a transition of seasons. They forget.That air is thin, often cold. At last, it seemed I had found Shangri-la. But maybe I had not found Shangri-la.
我心目中的香格里拉是没有钢筋水泥，只有石头和木头，还有那些幸福的人，而没有现代文明人的骚扰，尤其没有商业气氛。
I went back to Jokang Temple, looking for the monk. I could not find him. I went back, looking for the cup of yak butter tea I had been drinking 2 days before. Sure enough, I found the cup of yak butter tea.It was partly, but not completely empty. It was full of butter, but no tea. The tea had evaporated. The yak butter had already dried. In searching for Shangri-La, I must leave the city. Or maybe I don't need to leave the city to enter.Another realm.
I was born in the city. I was born in the city. I was born in the city. And I also like the city. I am a very
unlike the city. Can you see, I came to
Beijing. I don't like any
city. I'm not saying I don't like Beijing.
是比沈阳我的家乡我的出生地更大的一个城市，然后我又这两年又来往于纽约，
不喜欢啊纽约
和北京，
我也去过北京，也去过很多地方，
我是只要是城市我就不会喜欢，
我就是很一直向往城市的，我已经学会在城市里边怎么样去怎么样保持自己的心态。
其实有的时候我想我特别羡慕那些完全个人能完成的一些艺术家，
对，
你比如说像画家，
因为我在这里可以找到我内心深处最好的东西。我叫昂桑，我是个藏族画家，在很多大都市里很多很多东西都已经被破坏了，看不到了，在拉萨在西藏现在还是一片净土，还可以看到很多原始的很多宗教，很多西藏的那种原始文化，很多喀巴人从很远很远的甚至是上千公里啊到拉萨来朝佛，他是磕那个长头，磕一步走一步，磕一步走一步，一直磕到拉萨来啊，你想想当时那种感觉给我印象非常深。完了朝圣对那个藏族本身来说是一种很神圣的事情，因为他一辈子很远的地方到拉萨他只能来一次，完了他来了一次到大昭寺朝了佛以后他就回去了，有些到拉萨达到了他的那种境界以后他就在大昭寺就圆寂了。
历史角度来讲，大昭寺的作用，因为它是最早修建的佛教建筑物，
对，
我相信它是香格里拉它的这个基地，然后往四面八方的青藏高原长了很多枝，而且现在的枝已经不仅仅是西藏，
对，
还有很多内地的
喇嘛庙，
还有蒙古草原，
蒙古草
还有现在的西京、不丹、尼泊尔那边有很多藏传佛教，相信它的枝将来更茂，而且掉到整个世界。
The temple is surrounded by brass prayer wheels, which Nimat Sirin explained have prayers tucked inside. So if you turn the wheel, it's the same as saying the prayer. You can turn them clockwise, but not counterclockwise. Clocks cannot be turned backwards. In the whirling of wheels, I was searching for Shangri-La.
首先，您的这个想法非常好。想法非常好，完了我觉得你应该了解很多藏族的一些文化，完了他的一些宗教，
我是说佛门弟子，如果我把这个话说错了大家可以理解，
一个画家也好一个人也好，你首先要学会做人，
佛教的时候说真正的幸福就是知足，
因为你做人，做人的根本是一个善，
就是我现在已经行了够了，
宗教也是这样，
知足常乐，
以善为本，
藏传佛教它有个缺点就是吃肉，虽然它是佛教里面不允许的，但是由于这个我们这个环境，当时这个青藏高原是个高原，缺寒，
对，
而且是游牧为生的一个民族啊。
是，
虽然杀生是有罪的，但是由于人这个东西很珍贵啊，为了它的生存，你允许杀一点点的小那个生命去维持它，最后你可以去报答它，吃的它的生命，把你的就是生命维持下来，你好好去研究，好好去学。而且去将来去就是为他谋更大的福啊，
对，
但是很可惜今天不是这样，今天为了你这个就是跨国公司一个或者两个，为了你自己的大名义或者什么东西，他虽然知道我将来这样横行霸道的去夸张的话对这个宇宙这个环境不利，他自己知道，
对，
但是他自己由于欲望太膨胀了，如果我不干的话那么他的公司肯定有干， 他们就竞争。所以我觉得这个竞争就是把这个环我们的母亲大地母亲自然就是去毁灭它竞争。这个到时候包括他自己在内的还有所有的生命得到的东西就是越来越少。
所以我们画家的责任呢也是一种通过自己的绘画形式让更多的人知道环境的重要大自然的重要。
我们的祖宗后代永远要生活就是这个家园没有其他地方。我们科技再发展我不相信搬到月球上去。也不相信搬到太阳山去。我们人类和我们生命最理想的家园就是地球再也没有其他地方。
After leaving Tibet, I traveled to Qinghai. The road was long, and I often slept in the back seat of trucks or jeeps I was lucky enough to flag down hitchhiking. Drivers were not used to stopping for hitchhikers, especially a foreign one. But some stopped, partly out of interest, partly for amusement. One old driver kept practicing his English with me the whole time, the whole long road.I could not sleep. I could not think. I could not look out the window at what was passing by. He just kept speaking English at me. Finally, I got off and just walked. Qinghai. I was searching for nomads. They are hard to find. At 3,000 meters
above sea level.Qinghai belongs to the nomads, gypsies, whose life knows no boundaries, no concept of limitations. This is where one can reach to the sky and almost touch eagles, who are unafraid to fly close. This is where you come in the late afternoon to watch your shadow grow, extend intoinfinity and disintegrate into dust as the sun sets over the next horizon. It is only another plateau in the search for Shangri-La.
Zaijian.
You must follow a road which leads in no particular direction and keep following it. Nomads travel where there are no roads. This is what makes them nomads. They move like the wind. You cannot keep up. When you try to find them, they disperse. So you must concentrate on dispersion.I'm still following the smell of nomads. I'm still following the wind. The smell of yak butter tea brought me to a small town. Since coming to Qinghai, this was the first place where I could find lots of people. Of course, I had never been here before, but it seemed strange since everything here was so familiar. In the corner of the restaurant, a monk was drinking yak butter tea as well. He told me, if I try to find nomads, I will never find them, because I am following the wind. Only when you stop following and face the wind will you feel connected with the wind. So I stopped searching, and the nomads appeared. I found nomads who represented Shangri-La in my mind. They are the masters of Shangri-La. But when I asked them about Shangri-La, they just laughed and said maybe. In my world, people are just herded like yaks and sheep. Maybe it's time to break out. Maybe we can't.
你好，你好，欢迎你。这是牦牛的第一个厂，是吗？牦牛奶酪加工的就是第一个厂，就是这个牦牛的。哎，对，是吗？牦牛的，可以看看。哎，可以。好。
你周围什么都没有，你为什么在这里来投资一个梯次工厂？
我们的这个母鸡比较分散，他们的这个奶子没地方送，所以呢，我在这个地方建一个。
奶酪厂以后呢，整个母鸡的奶子都送到这里来，
对，
天天送到这里来。
哎，对对对对，
然后是他们用传统的那个做法，传统的奶就送到这里来加工做。
哎，对对对对，起子。
那起子卖到哪里去？
这个我们出口，往哎美国，
美国。
啊，对对。
还有哪里？
还有香港有一点。
是吗？
哎，对。
那个起子是那个西藏那个传统的做法吗？ 传统的做法再加上一个就是，我们当做一个传统的它这个干酪一个做法，再加上呢就是这个现在我们加工的这个是主要是瑞士的传统方法，
是你把瑞士的传统方法跟西藏的那种传统方法，
对对，联合到一起，为了一个国际方法，对，那就是因为就是你要把那个传统的那种 cheese 品味啊，谢谢，就编一下，就为了他们外国人能够习惯。哎，
能够习惯，非常喜欢。这个工厂是谁的想法？这个工厂是我的想法。我这个厂子办的目的呢，一个是为这个本地的牧区增加一点收入，再加上就是我把这个奶酪加工了以后往外移卖的话，我把这个奶酪的有些那个利润呢，可以用到我们学校。
学校。
对，我还有一个学校。
你还有一个学校？
对。奶酪厂的所有那个的利润呢，就投入到这个学校。
那这个学校是主要是给哪些孩子？
主要是牧民的。
这个很美，这是你们自己建起来？
对，这个就是我们的垫脚石。垫脚石
是吗
？In the late summer, the children are on holiday, but Jigme Jensen is busy making plans.
现在咱们。也可以上网，也可以这个是吧？打字什么都可以。
Planning to break ground on yet another school for nomad girls, I ask him why the school is so far away from any town. By having the school here in the mountains, Jigme Jensen explained, their traditional lifestyle will not be affected.I do not want to build a school in a place which might be inconvenient for the nomads.
我们这个地方不仅仅是藏族，也有汉族，也有满族，都有学生里面也有。只要是贫困的，我就可以接受。
他们有学费吗？没有。
不收学费，我这是免费的。
免费给他们。
免费。
然后那个学校在哪里？
学校在拉加镇，也就是在拉加寺的旁边。
拉加寺的旁边。
对。
你跟拉加寺有什么关系？
拉加寺是我的母寺，我在拉加寺当古主持。
This temple is different from Jokang Temple, as there are no tourists, no visitors. There are caves beside the temple, where monks have come for centuries to meditate. Some still come here today. Meditation concentrates concentration.It can bring one to their most central point of being, oneself without self, a process of arrival and departure without leaving or asking where you have just come from or where you will go next. Concentration is focused on mantra, prayer of giving and death, a call to white eagles encircling above, acutely aware of all which passes below.They too can hear mantra uttered in the most elemental realm of your own subconscious.
古洛咒，有一个麻多县，这就是黄河源头。从黄河源头到这儿有两个弯曲。现在这个弯道是比较，就是，按照这个佛教的地心来说的话，这个是非常好的地形。所以呢，这个我们拉加寺，就是监寺制叫做。阿日格西切木，他认为是这个是建寺的最好的地点是这个。
那如果我说要不要搬到城市里，你搬不搬去？
城市我以前也是待过，我是挺喜欢的。
你挺喜欢吗？
我在哪里去，我也不习惯。
都是习惯了，但是如果你是城市住或者在这里住，你觉得哪个地方好？
我觉得在哪个地方都一样，
都一样，
我哪里都住得惯。
The wind was here first. You cannot keep up with it. If you try to catch the wind, it will behave elusive.And mislead you into following dust blowing in all directions. This is a place where the desert is surrounded by snow-capped distant mountains, Shangri-la, white mountains, which can only be reached through hiking across dunes of sand, which cannot be crossed. This means that the mountains are unreachable. No such place ever existed in your mind, so you believe it must be an illusion. You even insist.Because now you are facing the wind. When your own image has finally shattered, dissolving into blowing sand, you will see the mood of your soul reflected in your shadow. Now it is time for you too to walk into the desert.
我认为现在云南已经成为了一个中国文化的一个中心。 无论是从历史的这种多元文化、民族文化来看的话，它已经成为一个中心。同时，在当代这一块，它也成为了一个中心，一个 international city。
我们呢，实际上是在这种大都市工作了十多年。在这种繁华的都市里边呢，我们感觉就是有点心里面受的这种压力。
我会要这个地方。
到这边一看呢，和这种心态正好是反差特别大。它太接近自然了。
有些艺术家他们来在上面工作，住在我们的另外的一个空间，同时呢他们使用这个空间做一个 open studio。
它是天天在流动的，这种感觉一下子就把我们给带到这种要在这边做点事。
现在的这样的环境，就是艺术家他自己的角色和身份已经变了，就是艺术家已经变成一个游牧的
岳敏君的作品。
一方面他生活在自己原来的这种文化里面，中国文化里面，同时呢他也生活在一个不同的思想和不同的文化里面。
像那个是杨少斌的东西，还有一些日本的艺术家、英国的艺术家，
在这样的一个游历的这种状态里面，他同时呢他也在寻找一个更加吻合他的这种生活方式。
这个地方可以说是一种那个艺术家的公社，也可以这么
对他。因为是我们不是用一种商业的方式来做这样的地方，就是不是我把这个地方租下来再转租给别人，我们只不过是像发动群众一样的。
这是那个唐志刚的工作室
啊，这画的康僧
教毛主席打枪，然后这是艺术家本人，他说他在劝毛主席不要打枪。
东西都是很辛苦，都要到那个江西的景德镇，就是中国出产陶瓷的那样的一个瓷都去烧制。这些就是他的，这些都是原来最传统和最经典的一些陶瓷。
Cheng Xingdong divides his time between Beijing and Paris, representing China's upcoming artists. He encouraged me, if you want to find Shangri-La, you must go to Yunnan. It's the happening place, the alternative. You will find things there, the unexpected.
Didn't expect to find, of all things, an alternative rock concert in Yunnan.
So how'd your concert go last night?
Exceedingly well. In spite of the rain.
We nearly got rained out, and it was pretty terrible because the whole carpet on the stage was soggy. It would squish under every footstep, and I had sort of electric current running through me the entire time.
Really?
It was like poor grounding. It was sort of like licking a 9-volt battery for the duration of a 40-minute set. But the crowd was really enthusiastic. We played our little hearts out.
Right.
We were sort of the only band that was sort of, you know, the last of the long-haired arena rock metal kind of guys. So. It went over really well. They were really getting into it. It was, it had that in common, at least with Woodstock, that it was wet. It was really soaking wet. Today is looking to be much better.
this a real Woodstock festival?
Oh, lots of people they compare to.
Right?
It's some kind similar. Maybe the, you know, for just the 形式, right? The
right.
way, yeah, it's similar. But I think it's still different.
Now in China, you see things like Dada Wa, this
right.
Zhu Zhiqin, who's a Han nationality woman who's really capitalized on this whole craze for things,
right.
you know, from the Yunnan plateau and from the Tibetan plateau. You know, the batik clothes and all the silver jewelry and all that sort of, you know, the shrouds and that sort of mystical look.
So, is this your bar?
It's called Dada Wa. It belongs to everybody.
So it's for everyone?
Yeah, just like, you know, whatever you keep to looking, right?
So, like your music then, it's for everybody?
I would like to call myself music Dada Wa music. Because I'm not New Age, you know? Have you heard about New Age?
Yeah, Kaiser told me about it.
This whole phenomenon of New Age music, the sort of exoticization of sort of the mystic Oriental music.
So the New Age also is a kind of background music, right?
Sambao had his own view on New Age music.
80年代初开始有这个所谓的New Age音乐或者说World Music这种音乐开始 首先是Enigma开始做这样的一个音乐 它主要就是把一些很民间的东西 各个不同的民族的民间的东西给它很原始的东西素材拿过来然后用很现代的一些节奏啊还有和声啊这样的把它做出来这样一个东西 它做得很纯粹
What is it that the artists are trying to seek And what is it that the audiences are listening to?
The artists are trying to seek audiences.
很多人把各个民族不同的东西融汇到一块儿，也是现在的音乐一个大的趋势。因为我想，可能其他的文化门类也是类似这样，就是一个大融合的阶段。
You know, all that bullshit. I mean, it's just it personally makes me want to puke.
后来有很多很多人在做这样的东西，但是你突然发现有很多很多做的很烂。
商业化，很商业化，对，就是很表面化，对，每个人都觉得好像就拿一些很原始的素材往里边一放就可以了。I mean, it makes me sick. It really makes me sick.
Why does it make you sick?
比如说像在拉萨啊，你突然发现一个喇嘛在一个上面标着中国电信的一个，
对，
那个什么下面站着，然后打这么一个现代化的铜具，你就会觉得很奇怪，
对，你说不上来
这是一种什么样的感觉，对，就是一种。 淳朴的东西，或者是原始的东西，跟现代东西一个那种撞击也好，是融合也好，就觉得很生硬。
It's just because it's so clearly just this cynical attempt to milk this trend, this new age trend. These helpless, searching middle-aged women who are, you know, looking for some meaning in life that they haven't somehow been able to find in Catholicism, which is so ridden with, you know, pedophilic priests, or in Protestant Christianity with Bible-thumping assholes.
就如同前天吧，在 大昭寺广场看到一帮模特，以大昭寺为背景走过，然后据说他们可能过几天要在参加一个比赛，背景是布达拉宫。你就往前走，他挡着你道，你就给我撞他，听见没有？啊？为什么要这么做？我很厌恶这样的东西，如果很真实，我是在亵渎这个东西，很表面。 你觉得这样就会怎么样了吗？如果以一个很有历史的、很有宗教色彩的一个东西为背景来做这么一个东西，就能说明什么吗？说明是什么呢？说你想说明什么呢？说明是一个现代文化跟传统文化的一种什么撞击融合？我觉得。
This stuff has, like so many other things, been sort of re-imported into China, into the Chinese consciousness, via the West, which is a sort of sad irony. Let's take, for example, fashion.
I think it's because, first of all, it's very simple. They've run out of things to do, and they've never traveled. 80% of the people in America have no passports. So when they come out, they're like, wow, they're shocked. Even Chinese artists go out from Asia. Even Asian people in Hong Kong, Singapore has never been to these places. And when they come, they're stimulated by it. They are like shocked. That's why they're doing it. And of course the media promotes it. And then people say, oh, but it's from the West now. They gotta be cuckoo. It's just promotion has promoted it that way because there's somebody. And because Donna Karan's using ethnic things, Armani's using ethnic things, Gucci's using ethnic things, that's why they think it's a Western thing. It's just media's game.
It wasn't long ago that you just never saw Chinese people wearing, you know, the high Mandarin collars, right, and the Chinese buttons and the silk brocade and the lime green sort of, what's that, you know, Shanghai Tang look or whatever, the fuchsia. And that was all popularized in the West. And once it became sort of acceptable on the runways in Milan and in Paris and in Tokyo and whatnot, then suddenly it's back in China and in force. It's sort of a boomerang effect, which is kind of ironic. This is something that originated in China that the Chinese people forsook for whatever reason and has now, you know, made a reappearance.
In social Shangri-La is, if you don't, the future will be nothing if you don't go back to something.
My music is have a great influence from the, you know, traditional Oriental music,
right,
religion,
right,
and you know, culture, everything. But we use a really new technology.
Right.
But you know, as soon as you finish it, you can feel, you know, the equipment.
Yes.
We just can feel the, you know, very spiritual level.
Right.
That's all the artists, the literature. We have to do that to tell the people. We still have the way to go. We don't just have one way, you know, to computer. It's,
right,
it's the way to help us to do that, to finish our world.
It's only a tool, right?
Yeah.
I take the CD cover, and it has a little sticker affixed to it that says, with protective mirror, and it's got this little bagua, you know, the hexagram diagram with this little cheesy mirror tacked into the middle of it, and all over it, it's got all sorts of, you know, Chinese this, Chinese that, you know, the names of the songs on it are like mountain, cloud, river, you know, it's, and I look at it, you know, the guy's got some bullshit, you know, Sanskrit name that he's picked. I flip through it, and you know, his actual name is like, you know, Heinrich von Ullmann or something like that, some fucking German guy. Mountain, cloud, river.
<音><音><音><音><音><音><音><音><音>
So it's really great to touch my heart. And I started to have a conversation with the mountain. We can talk.
因为你想你到了那种地方一望无际 人见得很少，然后出去放牧放羊，一天就他一个人，没有人跟他去讲话，他就是去唱歌，因为那个地方太大了。任何，我想任何一个人到了那个地方哈，视野如此的开阔，如此的看不见人，你到那个地方唯一特别想做的事情就是大喊。
I found Yang Liping, China's legendary, most celebrated dancer, sitting on the floor of her dance studio, back against a mirror. I had seen these hands before. Guanyin fingers, Buddhist mudra, the most famous hands in China, maybe the world. Yang Liping never went to dance school, but she had become China's greatest dancer. A bi-ethnic minority, she began dancing along the lakes and Dali as a child, then to Yunnan's mysterious Shishuangbana, where inspired by the natural life there, she created her own style of dance, peacock, fire, moon.
贴近自然，贴近人性本身，生命本身是最有说服力的，而不是一个空谈的哲理。那么舞蹈本身也是这样，如果我们脱离了这个，我们就轻了，我们没有分量，我们没有一个后证，没有一个底蕴，我们没有了自己。Yang
Liping had been traveling tirelessly for months to Yunnan's most remote villages, searching for traditional unspoiled song and dance. Rapid development would soon change these villages. Oral traditions would soon be forgotten. She brought these village children back to her studio with their songs and dance, the essence of village life. She was saving their culture.
佤族人，他崇拜太阳，他就是他的哲理。他说他那个太阳，太阳是，他那种他不知道，他不懂科学哈，他不懂那宇宙学，他就知道。
今天他们还是他们表演用的衣服，都是一代一代穿过来。
对，他奶奶穿下来的，他妈又穿，他妈现在又拿给他穿，是这样。然后他用。他如果有女儿了，他女儿又可以穿。你看刚才打鼓那个服装，他的色彩，他的花的，他是很有很现代的。
他们这个服装就从头到脚，每一套服装都有八件，因为这个一套服装缝制下来，他要经过三年的时间。这些都不是用布打出来，都是一针一针、一个针一个针的挑出来的这些花纹。
是你的意识，是你能不能够欣赏这个现代，而不是说你去表层的去感觉现代，而是你能不能有这个能力去欣赏他们的现代。
They want to look like everybody else.
Very artificial.
这种城市，它怎么可能留住人？它没有回忆，没有人的感觉。
但是有些文化人，为什么艺术家他愿意去那边呢？因为现在那边还保留了这么一种纯粹，还可以找到一个宁静。这一点的话，在其他的城市就越来越少，这种范围就越来越，就是可能性就越来越小。
Xingdong told me to find artist Luo Xu. His studio was in the outskirts of Kunming. He lived alone in his own world, alone with a pet mule. Luo Xu did not talk to me about his art. Instead, he talked to me about Shangri-La. He told me, if you want to find it, then you must go to a place called Zhongdian.
我第一次去中甸就是正好这一季节，秋天的已经变化多端的，刚刚进入小中甸，坡一翻过去啊，当时就吓我一跳，马上人就稀了，就软化了。突然呢，有一丝阳光，哇，那个光下来以后就产生了很多很奇怪啊，那个颜色我实在没法形容，就是非常奇怪。那些喇嘛觉得这是天赐的，他们那种吉祥、一种特殊的一种光芒，他们马上就要匍匐念经，再也不看了，然后就闭着眼睛，不停地念经，就用心在感受眼前的大自然赐给他们的光景。我觉得那种现象就是香格里拉的其中的一个部分。你走的每一步，每一个小花小草、野花野草，每一只小鸟，都是香格里拉的一部分。这么一个神秘的概念是不会待在都市里面，不会待在四方街，不会待在大理的洋人街的，不会的。中甸更对路一点，因为这个地方人为的造化痕迹很少，那么我觉得这个东西就待在那个地方，不是待在一个所有人都去见他的一个地方。
你好，
你好，
我们是找香格里拉，香格里拉是不是这个方向？
你们从哪里来？
是，我们就是从北京来。
这样？
对对对，是不是这样走吗？然后我们从拉萨开始。
不能吧？
啊？
可能是往这条路。
走到青海。
这里走不通啊。
走不通。
是。
走到丽江，然后走到这儿来。
今天就到这里。
就找香格里拉，这是不是香格里拉？
是
吗？是吗？
是。
那怎么走？
往这条路。
往这条路，
这全部都属于是香格里拉的。
这是不是在那个希尔顿在书里边写的是香格里拉？
是，
是吗？
是。
那就应该是到那边去。
这边。
这边走。
嗯，香格里拉县城在下面。
还得过这个山，对不对？
要过。
过。
绕过去这边。
那
有个海。
是不是要找香格里拉要，就是还得过一个山，还得绕个山，是不是？嗯。中式都是这样的，
嗯，这些全部都属于香格里拉，
全都是香格里拉，
嗯，山和这些属于全部都是。
那其实香格里拉是到处都有。好，这样吧，你带我过这个桥过去，好吧？
现在的哥哥来，这边
来。我在这个路线走，我发现到有一个争论，这争论是几个地方都说他们是真正的香格里拉，这个争论是怎么发生的？
1997年，云南省人民政府就在这儿发布了一个研究成果，
嗯哼，
说中甸就是香格里拉。
OK，
之后呢，丽江也说它是香格里拉。然后是四川省的稻城县也说它是香格里拉。
You must be looking for your own Shangri-La, are you?
Yes.
Have you found it in Zhongdian? Is this the real Shangri-La?
Partly, yes.
Why did you eventually root here in Zhongdian, the legendary Shangri-La?
You see here, in this grassland right in front of the hotel, you know, right in the city of Gelpan and Zhongdian, we have at least 60 different varieties of wildflowers.
Right here,
right
over
here.
60 different varieties of wildflowers.
That's right.
Where we're sitting.
If you were here in May, in end of May through middle of June to third week of June, you wouldn't believe how many flowers there are here. That is a trend all over China. Big developers go to a pristine area. It's happened in Lijiang, it's happened in other areas of Yunnan, and other cultural areas of China too. They come in and their concept of tourism may be having an entertainment park. There are hundreds of entertainment parks all over China. I don't see why one needs to repeat it and have one here. Here, our uniqueness is that we are in a region which is one of the 200 high biodiversity spots of the world. So we have to find ways of protecting that biodiversity, leaving it as natural and as wild as possible. There is an effort to help two of the villages at the base to earn from tourism and protect the area. Now, they have a commitment to protect the area because it's their own land, as it is. And it's also a sacred mountain. It's their sacred mountain and their sacred lake where they go to pray. So there is a project to help the communities earn, because that's one of the principles of ecotourism, is to bring in as much income as possible for the local communities.
Right.
So they, in turn, will conserve their own land.
Right.
So there is a project set up there, but there's a fear of a big developer coming in and taking in 50 square kilometers to set up an entertainment park. And that is exactly what should not happen here. That's what will change Shangri-La.
To think about building on the authentic
In reality, Shangri-La is a consequence of commercial promotion. In my mind, Shangri-La should be a world that local people don't leave for tourists. Don't leave in tourism.
And I do agree that it's tremendously important to ensure that it remains that way. I do worry very much, though, about using something like Shangri-La, which is a Hollywood myth, to try and maintain something that has its own authentic heritage, its own authentic roots.
Shangri-La means many things to many people and different things to different people. It is not only biodiversity, it is not only cultural diversity, it is not only mountains, it is not only spiritual aspects.
I don't bother about Shangri-La much. I bother more about this area. And if we can keep the culture of Tibetans, the Nashi, the Yi of the Malimasa alive, then these mountains will stay alive and will keep the environment. But we shouldn't sell
it. We got a wonderful welcome from the government here. Anything we wanted to do was fine.
One cut of the palace.
I hope that it's not a nominal effort that is made, but it's a real effort to save the identity. And this can be only done if people have the chance. People with their own historical identity, and not an invented, officially invented identity, that people themselves decide what is the future they're going to take.
所以我希望我们人类不仅仅开发这个能有的同时，最主要的就是要开发你内心的香格里拉。这个香格里拉是永恒的，没有限。但是我们的这个宇宙，这个大地，这个母亲是有限的，你不能去横横幅化的。真正的英雄，hero们，不是战胜自然，不是战胜我们这个环境，我战胜这个世界，这个我们不算英雄。 我们的英雄就是战胜自我的烦恼，去把你的香格里拉困起来的这个，就污染的这个东西。我们佛教里边说自私、愚昧、无知，就是只光知道哦这样去做，好像眼前有利益，这最后还是没有，反而自己的烦恼增加了。
自己的心理压力太大了，没有着落。我有钱，我有工厂，所以我举个例子，我们西方的大资本家，
对，
他本来是这个工厂的主人，但是很多有理性和学佛的人看他就是那里面的奴仆，
对，
机器的奴仆。但是我更不幸福，甚至还不如那个要饭的这个非常轻松的人。这就是香格里拉。
我认为呢，香格里拉就是西藏
真正的香格里拉，不仅仅到西藏是找到是不可能的事情。
再走得远一点，去丽江，去中甸，因为那种地方自然的力量是很强大的。
香格里拉就是丽江，
丽江不能代表香格里拉，你说的是那个精神。
Shangri-la is a place in northern northwest Yunnan。
真正的香格里拉在云南德县藏族自治地区。香格里拉是最美的美的一个圣地。
中甸真的是香格里拉吗？它这么完美吗？
我说你们别傻了，到处都是香格里拉，在整个藏区每一个角落都是香格里拉，就是一个猪圈都跟香格里拉有关系，是吧？
对，
就是一个牛棚都跟香格里拉有关系。
Tibetans believe our present world of war, disease, corrupt inequality.And environmental desecration is the self-destructive age of Kali, to be followed by a new age of peace, ethnic harmony, environmental balance, and human dignity yet to come. The future is Shambhala, sometimes called Shangri-la.
我是想香格里拉是找不到了，真正找到了，我感觉也没大意思。
Why?
就搞成有一个结果啊，这就是香格里拉。那我觉得我就太失望了啊！这他妈，这是什么香格里拉？这
……I was looking for a direction, but nobody has a clear direction. So I came to Zhongdian. Should I be here?
找香格里拉，你到这儿找就对了。这就是香格里拉。
What is Shangri-la?
It's a fictional notion dreamt up by a guy by the name of James Hilton for a book that he was writing.
In Hilton's book, Lost Horizon, he described Shangri-La as a hidden mysterious valley with prairie grasslands, surrounded by mountains on all sides, with golden pavilion rooftops of temples touching the sky. So, one eventually must come here,to Zhongdian County, Yunnan Province, in the search for Shangri-La.
It might or might not have been predicated on a real physical location that might or might not have been near Zhongdian or near Lijiang or near Dali, somewhere in...
你想想那个描写的那种香格里拉是什么感觉？
I'm not sure what it is. There's something about...
桃花盛开，不败，清清的水。没有任何的这种坏人，有美好的树，没有暴力，有美好的自然，有很多的爱，爱情，没有死亡，美丽的衣服，有美丽的女人，美丽的男人，走路在飘着，怎么可能有呢？不可能有，
绝对没有，
是吗？
He said James Hilton never came to Yunnan.
我们不用去拷贝一个就是所谓的希尔顿用文字描写出来的那样的东西。
那他没来过这儿，怎么写山归来？
第一个进入藏区的英国人是1724年，他是从那个喜马拉雅山的南地进去的，然后他到了那个鸭绿江浦江边，然后进去到那个日喀则，那么他把这个资料呢搞成以日记的形式放在那个大英博物馆里，这份日记就非常出名，后来呢就引来了大量的英国人。拿过来，
他本身就是在消失的寻找，他在寻找，
寻找，对，
他说可能这个是香格里拉，
所以可以说 希尔顿作为一个搞创作的人，实际上他可以凭借大英博物馆的资料找到香格里拉很多感觉。
我们不断地去验证希尔顿的那个香格里拉是哪一段木头、哪一根树、哪一片草原，不是那样的东西。我觉得香格里拉实际上在每个人的身边也可以被发掘出来。
Then one day, American military satellites picked up intelligence, which raised suspicions, deep concerns, believing they had found a missile base in Shangri-La, with weapons of mass destruction pointed in all directions. Of course, diplomatic crisis soon dissipated when the Chinese government revealed that the wooden scaffolds, which dot farmland throughout Zhongdian, are only used by innocent Tibetans to dry barley on.From crushed barley, they make zampa, their basic source of vitamins and sustenance. When mixed with yak butter tea, it tastes a bit like muesli or granola. Imagine how so many of the world's problems could be solved and diplomatic crisis avoided if certain governments only took the time to understand local cultures and ethnic lifestyle values. Just think about it for a moment. Anyway,Who could imagine weapons of mass destruction in Shanghai?
Shangri-la 这个词啊，首先代表的是一个文化的理念，它是藏族文化的一种核心。这个核心呢，它就是人与自然和谐。
这个社会变得越来越现实，越来越商业的时候，我觉得这个提出寻找香格里拉是需要勇气的。
But when?
Sometimes it comes just before the day you die. Sometimes it comes.With the lightning, sometimes it comes with the thunder. Sometimes it comes when you're back in your office in New York. Sometimes back in.
我觉得香格里拉这样对一个美好的东西的一个想象是永远都是一个形而上的。如果把这个东西过分的现实化，其实是没有意思的，就是你会失望，特别的失望。
香格里拉是没有地方的。你不能用一个地方或者是用一个物品来代表哪个是香格里拉，哪个是最好。
我总是觉得这是一个怎么说很理想化的东西，
找不到。
对。
For me, Shangri-La, you know, it's a real world. You have the experience. That's what Buddhists say.
Maybe Masirin has the answer.
佛法不是佛创作的，是佛发现的真理，但它不是救世主。你每天拜他，只是提醒你寻找香格里拉，但是他不是帮你去找香格里拉，是你自己去找。 找到真正的香格里拉，我觉得这个世界就是天堂。我们的天堂不在远处，就在这儿。同样，我们的地狱不在底下，就在这儿。最终，香格里拉就在心中，不在西藏，也不在其他任何一个角落。每个人的香格里拉。就在每个人的心中可以选择。